Hi guys, it's Maria here. Welcome back to my channel. This channel is about bags, lifestyle and fashion, but mostly bags. I post videos every Wednesday and Friday. I'm always on the hunt for the perfect bag. If you are like me, subscribe. Don't forget to subscribe, hit notification bell, and let's enjoy bags together. Everyone is talking about this bag. It's pretty much sold out everywhere in the black color. Influencers are on the hunt to get this bag. When one of my friends kindly offered me to review this bag because she found out there are not that many reviews on that bag online, and I totally agree with her, I didn't come across of that many, I couldn't say no. I just jumped into this opportunity and I'm so grateful for that. Thank you very much. And I'm talking here about amazing and one and only beautiful Prada Cleo bag. Today I'm going to do a little review. I'm going to mention a few flaws of this bag after I test driving that for quite a few weeks. I'm going to show you what we can fit in this bag, and believe me, you're going to be surprised. Unpleasantly or pleasantly surprised, we're going to find out this later. However, I promise there are going to be a surprise about the capacity of this bag. I'm also going to show you some close-ups and the mod shots, how I wear this bag. Without further ado, let's start talking about the beautiful cons of this bag. And the first of them is amazing, unique, original, aerodynamic shape. I love how Prada came up with that idea to revamp just an original, just a regular hobba bag, which still remains very, very trendy and fashionable in spring, summer 21. And they introduced this unique, and as I said, original shape. When I saw this bag at the very first time, I actually was surprised to find out that it's not just a flat bag, but has a little sloppy secret. And when I'm talking about sloppy secret, I'm talking about this slope from the front to the back of the bag. And as you can see, the front is shorter than the back, which makes this bag so unique and the original. And here I'm going to mention the first flaw of this bag. The original shape of the bag brings so much, making this bag so unique, but unfortunately, it doesn't bring anything to the capacity of the bag. And I'm going to mention more about that when it comes to the what fits section of the video. And I'm going to give you an example by filling this bag with my combo of essentials. Second thing that we definitely should mention here is amazing, unique. And again, I'm going to use that word because it's so different from any other bags on the market, brushed leather. We don't come across brushed leather very often when we're talking about just the regular bags on the market. It's something in between patent reflective leather, but it's not as reflective as it is, and just a regular Saffiano or a small grain leather. It's very delicate, very smooth, very tactile. I'm actually enjoying it so much when I'm touching this bag. It's very beautiful. And now I'm going to mention another flaw. Brushed leather unfortunately comes with the flaws, and it's very delicate, very, very delicate. As I'm going to show you more at the close-ups that my friend, only after using that for a couple of months, already scratched very badly, I would say, not very, but quite badly scratched one of the corners. And it's a few scratches over here as well. And she didn't do anything to this bag, or she didn't take it camping. You know, she didn't go hiking with this bag. She was just using it regularly or a few times a week. And that's how it affected the bag. So I would say in the wear and tear, that's not the best example, I would say, unfortunately. And again, if we're talking about brushed leather, I should mention here that please do not touch this bag with oily fingers, or don't spill anything on the bag, because there will be a marks and the stains on the bag. Luckily, they are very easily solved. This issue is very easily solved with a dry cloth and a tiny bit of water, just the usual, just a tap water, few drops, and a little clean with a dry cloth, just like polishing the leather, and then all stains or oily marks will be removed. If you're not in the house, if you just spill a little bit of coffee on the bag and you're just trying just to get rid of that, there will be a stains on the bag when it dries out. Be very careful with that. If we're talking about versatility of this bag, I would say as it is, if we are not adding on anything extra to the bag, it's not the most versatile bag either. It only has this top handle. It's just a regular hobble bag and that's it. It doesn't come with a strap, removable, adjustable, or any other options. And this strap also is not removable or adjustable. It could be easily hidden inside the bag. The form of the strap allows you to do that. And you can also carry this bag as the clutch. Me personally, I don't like the shape of the bag, just like in the clutch shape. I think it strap brings and adds so much to the bag and to this unique shape. I probably would not recommend to wear that as a clutch bag. However, side hoops, which attach the strap to the actual bag, has a hose. And ta-da! My curious mind come up with the idea to wear this with adjustable strap. For example, a strap, the white strap from my Prada Reedition 2005 in nylon, or any other thin or thicker strap off market or the Prada. I think this little extra, which I said does not come with the bag, will add a lot to versatility of this beauty. If we have a look into exterior and the interior of the bag, we can see that on the front, it has a beautiful Prada plaque, and apart from that, that's it. Pretty low key, I would say, apart from the Prada plaque, there is no much branding or anything into your face. No extra details, nothing added on, and no feet at the bottom. If we have a look inside the bag, we can see that it's a magnetic closure. Really easy to use the magnetic closure. And inside the bag, we have a large pocket, which could easily fit a really good size phone. I tried that with the iPhone 12 Max Pro. I believe it's one of the biggest phones on the market at the moment. And in the case, when the phone is actually in the case, it does not fit into this pocket. So just keep that in mind. If it's out of the case, yes, it's easier, but I usually don't wear that without the case. With the case, it does not fit inside this pocket. It could easily fit inside the bag though, but just keep in mind, not the pocket. And apart from this pocket, there is nothing else inside the bag. It's a fabric nylon lining with a Prada branding in there, like usually Prada does for all the recent bags, and that's it. And the little plaque Prada on the pocket as well, as you can see here, and that's it. And I believe that should add to the capacity of the bag, but we're going to find out about that in the next part of the video, what fits. And now it's time for what fits section. With my usual combo of essentials, I'm going to show you how much we can fit in this little beauty. I would call this bag a medium size. Let's find out if it actually has a medium capacity. And I also promised you a couple of surprises. And the first of them, and unfortunately it was an unpleasant surprise for myself. Maybe for someone it's not a surprise at all. And yes, it's quite obvious. I didn't think about that. And that thing is that you can't put the bag down like that. It's not going to stand still at all due to this slope at the bottom of the bag. And if you're going to the restaurant or taking this beauty out, you always need to think about leaning in on something. For the purposes of this section, I'm going to hold this bag still so we can just demonstrate everything what I'm trying to demonstrate, and I'm going to show you how much we can fit in there. And we will start with my absolute must have essential number one, and that's the phone. And as I mentioned, it's a Max Pro size iPhone. And as I said before, it's not going to fit in a little pocket inside the bag. So I need to put that just in the bag itself, in the main section. Then I've got a flat card holder here. It's going inside easily. Then we've got lip balm, lipstick, keys, and see, the more we're putting inside the bag, the quicker bag starting losing its shape. And if we're going to put the hand sanitizer there too, we're going to see that despite the fact that the bag is easily closed, it's losing its shape and things starting coming out. Yes, technically we can put more and more inside the bag, and you can see that it's a quite space left there. In this case, we wouldn't be able to close the bag because the bag will lose its unique and beautiful shape. And as I mentioned before, it's one of the main pros of this beautiful bag, this unique and original shape. And that, I would say, the second unpleasant surprise here, yes, unfortunately surprising and pleasant, that capacity, despite the size, despite the actual space inside the bag, is very limited, because you want to keep this beautiful and unique aerodynamic shape of the bag. I taken out the hand sanitizer, and I only left there with card holder, phone, yes, it's a large size phone, keys, lipstick, and a lip balm. Yes, we can add on a mask inside there too, but I would say that will be it. I wouldn't risk to put a large purse in there. And again, despite the fact that the large purse that actually would fit in there, it will ruin the shape of the bag. And that's the pity, that the bag is so beautiful and so promising in the sense of capacity. However, capacity is very misleading here. Now, quickly, I want to show you some close-ups of this beautiful Prada Cleo bag. First of all, I want to point out the delicate brushed leather. You might see some fingerprints on the bag just now, and I don't have any greasy fingers at the moment, but you can see how delicate the leather is, that there is a chance that you might see some fingerprints on the leather. And I also want to point out those scratches on the corners. As I said, I think in the wear and tear this bag is very delicate, and you need to baby that. I'm going to show you this sloppy bottom as well, and that's the difference between the front and the back of the bag. You can see, you can enjoy that slope over here, which creates that unique original shape and optical illusion. The bag has non-adjustable, non-removable strap, top handle, magnetic closure, and inside the bag I want to show you that it's a one big pocket, which is perfectly suitable for any type of the phones apart from the very large, for example iPhone Max Pro. Apart from this large pocket, there is no any other card holder slots or compartments. As I usually say, one big hole. It's a nylon lining inside the bag with a Prada branding. And that's it. Very simple outside and inside too. And I want to mention that beautiful Prada plaque on the front. And that's it. That's the beautiful Prada Cleo bag for you. Now I'm going to show you how I wear this bag. Just to remind you, I'm 163 centimeters tall, it's a 5'3", and I usually wear size 10 UK. As I mentioned before, as it is, as it comes, the bag is not very versatile. You can wear that in your hands, on the crook of your arm, or as a shoulder bag. I love how the shape of the bag allows you to sit back comfortably under your armpit. And because of this unique aerodynamic shape, and I've already mentioned that quite a few times, it creates a perfect space between your armpit, your body, and the actual bag. I find it's very comfortable and very convenient to wear that as the shoulder bag, and I'm not a massive fan of the shoulder bag situation. Bag doesn't come with a removable or adjustable straps. However, it has a hose on the hoops of the original strap where you can easily attach removable strap of the market one of the Prada. I'm actually thinking to use my wide strap from the Prada Re-Edition 2005 nylon bag and try that with this beautiful Prada Clear too. And just to conclude, guys, I just want to say that I'm quite surprised how much I like this bag, because when I saw this bag online, I wasn't like, do I actually like this bag, or I like this bag because it's so popular online at the moment and everyone is talking about that. And you know what, after test driving this bag for quite a few weeks, I can certainly say that I love this bag. It's beautiful shape, it's brushed leather. I'm even fine, but it doesn't fit so much because you know me and my mini bags. So I'm kind of like, I always carry a limited combo of essentials anyway. Am I prepared to pay over £1,500? And that's the price of this bag at the moment on the Prada website. I think it's £1,520, the most recent price. I think the Prada increased the prices recently too, like everyone else. Am I ready to pay that much for this bag with a limited capacity, with a very, very delicate leather? Probably my answer would be no. Again, I'm very grateful to my friend that she allowed me to test drive this bag for a few weeks. I wouldn't be buying that. It's beautiful, and if I ever come across the opportunity to use that bag again, to borrow this bag again, I would probably go for this chance again, but I wouldn't be buying this beautiful Prada Clio. And that's me for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video as much. I was enjoying test driving this bag. If you did, hit thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe. It's really important to subscribe, to stay tuned, hit notification bell, and let's enjoy bags together. And I see you next time. Bye.